Young record promoter named Joe Rock met a young singer named Jimmy Beaumont. Together, the duo would make rock and roll history with Joe's writing talents and Jimmy's voice. In 1959, the Skyliners would help shape the sound of Pittsburgh.
Every Saturday night, the family would get together. My grandfather, grandmother, uncles, aunts, and whatever, and have like a little party, because it was before television. And they'd sing the songs of the day, the songs on the hit parade, and I'd be down there amongst them, and you know, I'd be singing along with them and everything, and then I'd go to bed and hear them carrying on downstairs.
They were teenagers when they started off, and people could relate with that. They had both a good male group, and then they also had Janet Vogel rap in there, and so that they had the high notes that she could put in that ordinarily a group would have done with falsetto singing male.
Yeah, that was our local neighborhood group. I sang bass with the Monterays, and I sang a lead, Sympathy by the Cadillacs. And Joe Rock was there with his group, the Crescents. And after we came off stage, he approached me and said, you know, you sing lead real nice. He said, you're the bass singer, but you sing leads too. How would you like to join my group as the lead singer? And I
don't have... The Skyliners, from the first sound, they went wild. Everyone just flipped out on the Skyliners. They had a lot of enthusiasm, and it just came across in every song that they did. Since I don't have you, believe me, how much this I swear, that I would play these songs over and over and over and over again.
I don't have happy hours.
We've been very fortunate, and I'm just thankful and blessed.